was a good thing.
Oh, I got a white on. I got a white on.
Oh, I know it's not ladylike, but yes, I've just cracked a fat throat.
We are actually now going to take a little bit of a break, aren't we?
Oh, a well-earned break, I think, Miss Kenny, because let's face it, we've got to get to the bar as much as these young boys and girls need to.
And of course, we're going to take a very, very short break. And I want you to remember one thing.
What's that, Miss?
My great-grandmother told me this years and years ago. She always said to me, the more you drink, the prettier we're going to look in the second show.
So we'll see you a bit later on. See you in a little while.
Thank you.
Miss Kennedy, what would a drag show in the 90s be without a lot of ABBA? Probably pretty good. Now, we've got to give credit where credit's due. We would like to thank Tony Bartuccio for choreographing that number. Unfortunately, he choreographed it when he was in sixth grade.
Exactly, quite glad to get rid of it, basically.
Yes. He taught that to us, and of course, you know, we enrolled at the Tony Bartuccio School of Dance, and we paid a whole year's fees, didn't we?
Yeah.
And unfortunately, we only got to two classes. All that wasted money, Miss Kennedy.
It doesn't matter. The bottom line is we have grown.
Well, this is it. We've grown and we've matured as artists. And
the bottom line is who gives a rat's ass? But I mean, the bottom line is if they want to see great dance, they can go to watch the ballet.
Yes. This is it. You know, if you want to see precision dancing, just, you know, without any character or any human spirit, go and see, you know, a really shoddy production of the opera or something. You know.
Well, actually, Bob Seale Tate might be doing one.
Yes. Now, it's great to be here, of course, back here with the second show, because, wow, you know, we know you wanted more. You really did.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, we don't have steak knives tonight, do we, Miss Kennedy?
No, we don't.
No.
Now, we have got an artist we're going to introduce. We're going to come back a little bit of a chat.
Yes, because I think it's important to meet our viewing public.
Oh, definitely. Yes. Yeah, so, girls, hang on to your husbands. And your boyfriends. Actually, by the way, if there's any girls out there, I'm not that choosy. I don't care. I want to know. Anybody got a German Shepherd on them?
Our special guest, she is the gorgeous, the vivacious Miss Vivian St. James. Let's hear it for her.
Before you can count the one and nine, I can fill up a great big dipper of lye from the frying pan, throw it in the skillet, go out, do my shopping, be back for a melt in the pan, cause I'm a woman, W-O-M-A-N. I'll say it again. I can rub and scrub till this old house will shine like a dime. Face at the same time. Yeah, dressed up, go swing the bar, I am in there. Lay down a fire, jump off a six, or start all over again. God, I'm a woman, W-O-M-A-N. I'll say it again. God, I'm a woman, W-O-M-A-N.
too pretty. I don't like pretty.
Yes, actually, now you probably wondered why you don't see many old trannies around these days. And I'll tell you why. You see, we're very much the Lord Smith of the drag world, aren't we? And see, Vivian is a single gal, not unlike ourselves. And the thing is, it's so important, I think, you know, that we go out into the suburbs and meet the people in that, because unfortunately, if the trannies don't find a good home by the time they're 40, we have to put them down. But anyway.
Now, the bottom line is, as I said to you earlier on the piece, I mean,
very humane.
Think about it. Now, people have come to us and say, my God, Pandy, I'm sure you get lots of men racing up to you because you are so devastating. Yes. I mean, people don't realise that Barbara Cooks and myself used to be supermodels. We did. We were supermodels in a chew cup.
Yes.
We actually did very well at Target and Fossey's.
We were house models for Fossey's.
Unfortunately, I had to give the game away because my ass dropped. And you know what? When you're walking on a catwalk and there's skid marks, it ain't that attractive.
If we put our minds to it, went on a strict regime of exercise and good eating, I'm sure we could reclaim our supermodel status, don't you think?
Yeah.
And also, you know, 30,000 worth of elective surgery would go astray as well.
Now, the bottom line is people sometimes say to me, like, God, can you are so attractive? And I always say, yes, I know I am. And then I have another drink and I give them a drink. But the bottom line, I want you guys and girls to remember about the Box Hill TAFE, and of course the lovely Fountain's restaurant here.
Yes.
Because they call me the 0.05 of Fountain's restaurants as I start here. Look, the chefs are saying it, the bar staff are saying it, the management are saying it. They're calling me the 0.05 of Fountain's. I'm the old bag they all blow into at the end of the night.
We've got a lovely group over here. We met you briefly. We've got gorgeous blonde going into a convent. We've got the Rio Carnival girl. How are you going?
Fine, thank you.
Fantastic. Oh my God.
Oh,
Miss Hale
from the Cancer Institute.
Oh, really? Oh my God. Do you want us to do a pap smear?
Okay, girls, here you pull your breast out.
Yes. We've got a check for lumps.
Hang on, guys. One minute.
Oh, we could be spokesmodels for the Cancer Institute.
Hang on, look, no lumps. No lumps. Just a lot of old birdseed.
Maybe we can be spokesmodels. Now, Miss Kenny, who have we got over here? Let's go. Let's go in.
Active table.
Yeah. Oh, let's go into the audience, yes, because I think so. Now, we haven't got anyone from Box Hill. Where are you from, young man?
Camberwell.
Oh, that's local, isn't it?
Yeah.
We whizzed past Camberwell, actually, on the train on the way out here tonight. Our costs down when we go on tour. We always catch the tram or the train, but you know what I hate about when the dynamic duo goes on tour is we can't buy our daily travel cards on those trams now. But anyway.
We can use our concession cards, I think that's good.
Yes, the fact we're pensioners. Anyway. Now who's over here, Miss Kenny? Who's this lovely blonde lady here?
What's your name, sweetheart? Hi, Dorothy.
John, how old are you, Dorothy?
Oh, right. Oh,
no. Well, I hate to tell you, honey, but you're not in Kansas anymore.
This is a really pretty table. Now, look, we've got
Tammy Faye Baker over here. How are you, babe? You're not a representative for Mary Quant or Mary Kay. What's that? You know, they see those lovely ladies and those pink cars driving around?
Mary Kay.
Mary Kay, yes.
Actually, you've got more makeup on than I have, and that's a fact then. I mean, I've got more makeup on.
Actually, we're looking for a bit of filler for the finale.
You've got a hairy back as well. I was going to do my back because I always think a strapless gown always looks a lot more attractive and a lot more feminine. Don't you?
Yes. Now, who have we got over here? What's your name, darling?
Carol, welcome.
to Fountains. Of course, we prefer to call it Fountains because it sounds just that little bit more classy. I mean, Fountains, it's a bit common, isn't it? Anyone can say Fountains. But I think Fountains, it's just that little bit of French, isn't it?
Yeah, it's real classy.
Yes.
Now look, it's something else too, and I do apologise, because by the way, not a lot of people realise that during the day,
yes,
I'm a Ricky's labourer. I mean, I'm an apprentice Ricky's labourer.
Yes.
And of course, I'm only new at the job, so I always wear a very short skirt and high shoes. The bottom line is, I'm working on that Rollo building on the corner of Lonsdale and Spring Street.
Right.
And, you know, they're just about to do it, and well, they're getting a couple more floors happening. And I was in there the other day, I had my two bricks, I got into the lift. And I pressed the 24th floor, and a man got in on the 22nd. And the door closed, and I'm holding my bricks. He's looking at my skirt, my high stilettos, my lovely jewelry, my full sacred breasts, and everything else I haven't mentioned. And all of a sudden, the elevator sort of jammed, went like this, and he said, he looked at me, and sort of licked his lips like this, and then he said, "Can I smell your pussy?"
Oh,
what? I said, "What?" I said, "I beg your pardon." I said, "What?" He said, "Well, it must be your feet."
Oh, you're classy, Miss Candy.
Now, Barbara, I'm going to go and get ready for a quick change. Is that okay?
All right, yes.
Well, you think that...
All right, I think we just... It's always important... Oh, sorry, darling. Sorry, Dorothy. I think I stepped off Toto. Or Toto. Now, oh, my God. We've had a cancellation. We've had a group of youth. Now, it's always great to meet, I think, the people up the back rows, because sometimes they feel a little bit left out. You know, I mean, what's great about sitting that close is, you know, you can smell Miss Kenny Nye's fart. It's a little bit too close for a drag show, I think. I think we should always start the seating at about 30 feet, so you can squint, and then we look a bit more pretty. Now, you look fantastic. Oh, my God, you look fantastic. What's your name? Kiralee. Is that like the suburb? Is that like Kiralee House? Kirribilli. Oh, my geography was never that good. That'd be shocking. Wouldn't it be named after a house? What's the name? Oh, Kirribilli. Now, you look like a dead ringer for Celine Dion. You do. She does, doesn't she? Yes. I mean, I'm a heavy drinker, though. Yeah. Now, who's this lovely gentleman you're sitting with?
Oh, Rick.
Rick! Lovely to meet you, Rick. Now, enjoying the show?
Wow.
Fantastic.
Actually,
yes.
You look much better at the front.
Yes, I do. We really should work with an orchestra, so there's an orchestra pit between the stage and the audience. Now, we've got to say hello at this lovely table over here. Oh, my God, how are you going? Okay, now we've got a couple of bleached blondes over here. You're natural. Yes, naturally it's bleached. Yeah. Now, if that's natural, why do you dye your roots that murky brown colour? Oh, I think they've got the 2-for-1 bargain over here. Now, who have we got over here? Oh, you look very dapper, don't you?
Graham.
Graham. Oh, you look fantastic. You look very dramatic, don't you? So what? Yes, stand up for the lovely lady from Rio. She's single herself. Yeah, oh, and now Graham. Oh, my God. Oh, you've got the height, haven't you? Oh, you're such a big strapping lad. You even make me look girly, don't you? That's the thing about being a transvestite. It's so hard to find men with shoulders this wide and that tall.
Now,
what do you do, Graham?
I'm a salesman.
A salesman? Wow. With a smile like that, you could sell anything, I'm sure. What do you sell?
Sell copiers.
Copiers? Oh, fantastic. Well, we need photocopiers, don't we? Well, I mean, the girls at the typing pool, would you like to put in an order for the photocopier?
Yeah.
Yes. I'm afraid I don't have much need for one, Graham, so... Sorry, darling.
I said another time.
You're not the type of poor. Oh, Dudley. Well, if you go to Stocks, well, someone at Stocks College and train hard, get your words up. All right, now we're going to do a couple of little tributes. Now, oh my God, she, poor Vivian, she's multi. Oh, she is getting close to 40, isn't she? Oh, the poor thing, that's what happens to old drag queens, they just molt and go bald. Now, we're going to do a couple of tributes to a couple of favourite people of ours. And the first one is a guy who, he's not with us anymore and we miss him, but he blazed a trail for gals just like us. Please let's hear for the lovely, the fantastic Divine!
Fingernails, I thought they'd cheer, oh they'd cheer.
but I'm here.
Someone takes a smell, it's me.
Thank you so much, Box Hill. Oh, you know, Miss Candy, I know that this was such a great idea because really, this is just a stepping stone to New York, isn't it?
Frankston, at least.
Yeah. I mean, and if we can't crack that big town of Frankston, I think Carrigal welcome and fit to our
We did actually forget to mention, of course, too, if you have admired our costumes, of course, Babs and myself are big, big fans of Guru Tonya Todman.
Yes.
We make and sew and stitch on and glue.
Oh, yes.
And decoupage our own shoes.
Yes.
I love that show. I've even started to now crochet my own bikinis. You try putting a sleeve in one.
Now, Miss Kim, we hope that you have a great time, don't we?
We do.
We actually... Unfortunately, that brings us to the end of our show because... well, basically, we don't know anymore, so...
We've been together for 10 years, believe it or not.
Yes.
You've seen all the 10 years worth of COVID.
Yes. Right. You know, and you know, one day we might just both get the words right. Oh, well. Anyway. But it's been fantastic here tonight, hasn't it, Miss Candy?
It's been a wonderful audience. Have you just been terrific?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
You are 50 and the catering staff done a wonderful job.
Yes, we've got to thank the lovely people from the hospitality school and also the theatre technology people. They've been absolutely fantastic putting the whole thing together for us. I think it's such a sign of the times when, you know, drag theatre has become a diploma subject.
Vivian St. James.
Yes, unfortunately, yeah, we can't bring Vivian out to take a curtain call because she's actually had to be whizzed off to a prior engagement.
Yes, actually, we've got her in ice and she's going to come. We're going to bring her out again tomorrow night.
Yes.
Okay, so thank you. Would they now like to go into our things?
Yes.
We've been together for working together for about 10 years.
And as well, there's a lot has changed, Miss Candy, hasn't it?
Yeah.
You know, we've done some numbers and we've learned some new ones and left the old ones behind. But there's something that we've always carried with us, and it's a song that we borrowed from a couple of gals, not unlike ourselves. They grew up in Milwaukee, whereas we, of course, were Echuca supermodels. But, you know, I think it speaks a thousand words, our theme song, doesn't it? So I think we'll go out with our theme song.
Okay, thank you.
The alcohol's very cheap here, you'll have to excuse me. Miss Kenny's just powdering down, I think. We have rehearsed. this because we really didn't think we'd You'll have to excuse me, Miss Candy. It was the chicken. No, the food has been great here, but we didn't rehearse this. In fact, you know, we're the only drag duo in town who actually rehearse over the phone. We think it's just so much more 90s and civilised. We can't wait to get onto the internet. So step a little to the left, Miss Candy. Because, you know, we didn't know if you'd take us into your little box hill hearts. And so we haven't really prepared an encore.
No, we haven't really. And the last time we did this was in my lounge room.
Yes.
And by the way, I keep looking for my sideboard.
Yes. The choreography that we did for this a long time ago unfortunately completely throws us if there isn't a set of French doors there and a fireplace. So anyway, now we'll give them a little encore, won't we?
Let's do something for Priscilla. We haven't touched that tonight.
Wow, yes. We actually, that's a great idea because we really can't leave you without doing the Australian Drag Queen National Anthem. Which was given to us by that lovely Stephen Elliott. I love that Stephen Elliott. You know, what was fantastic about Stephen Elliott is just when, you know, drag was really archaic and, you know, we were looking very tired and washed up and everything, you know, we were able to do the same tired numbers for another 10 years.
We're just waiting for the sequel.
Yes.
Okay, yes.
And remember, if you like the show, please tell your friends. And if you didn't like the show, tell someone who cares.
I'd just like to say something too. If you drink drive, you're a bloody idiot. And if you make it home alive, you're a bloody legend.
All right, let's hear it, Mr. DJ.
Action! Evening, ma'am. And how are you? How do you enjoy the dynamic duo tonight?
I thought they were just amazing.
And it was the first time you've seen Barbara and Candy?
Oh, yes, very, very much so, yes, I have.
And did you enjoy the food tonight?
Yes, it was very good, very good quality.
And do you think you'll be coming back to see them again?
Oh, yes, I think they're just an amazing duo.
Okay, thank you very much. Enjoy the rest of your night.
Grazie, signore.
Enjoy tonight's show.
Fantastic, had a great time.
Yeah, and was it your first time seeing Barbara and Candy?
No, many times before.
And were they better here tonight than elsewhere?
They were just as good, but just a lot tamer.
The same old jokes, just a different venue, huh?
That's right.
No, not the same, just different jokes, they were tamer. They weren't as disgusting as usual.
And what did you think of the frocks?
Fantastic, yeah.
Yeah, they were good.
They were good.
Yeah. Okay. All right, well, enjoy the rest of your evening, gentlemen.
All right, thank you.
Where's it going? Okay, guys, I'm here with a piece of beauty outside the Dynamic Duo at the Fountains Restaurant. And can you tell us, what's your name, first of all?
Salome. And a piece of beauty, well, you know, one can question that. However, you know, the show was really magnificent, really dynamic, full of colour and life, something worth seeing, you know, something worth to fill, you know, your sides with laughter.
And what did you think of the frocks? Would you wear any of them yourself?
Well, you know, I think if I was to go to a glitter ball, I would definitely wear one of those frocks. Definitely, definitely, yes. In fact, I would choose one of them as my dressmaker.
And what are you up to for the rest of the evening?
Well, the rest of the evening, you know, we may be going to Barracuda nightclub, but
Barracuda.
You know, we're not exactly too sure what the evening will hold, but Barracuda holds some promise.
Okay. Well, you enjoy the rest of your evening.
Okay. Well, thank you.
Okay, welcome to Queer Zone, and here we are tonight at the gorgeous, it's Toss Bill, Dill Bill. Where are we exactly?
Darling, we're in downtown Box Hill.
Fabulous, and I'm not even going to introduce these guests tonight, because if you don't know who these gorgeous, lovely ladies are, well, you're still dealing in pounds, shillings and pence, obviously. We're at Box Hill TAFE, where the fabulous Dynamic Duo have been doing a fabulous show for the suburbs.
Yes, we've actually decided to take our act, as opposed to what a lot of the acts like to do, and move to the city, move to the big theatres. We like to do the suburbs in a big way. We like to do to the suburbs what we've already done to the city clubs, basically.
That's fabulous, Mrs. Candy. And Barbara, you were fabulous tonight.
Oh, darling, I mean, Miss Candy as my dance coach, I mean, I can do no wrong, really. I mean, she really is a Margot Fonteyn of the dance world, and it was ballet's loss when she, started growing over 6'4.5". And so, but anyway, I'm glad to be working with her, because she's actually teaching me so much about the art of dancing in a big production drag show like this one.
And it is a big production drag show too. Now, I did hear mentioned during the show that drag is now a diploma subject at all TAFE colleges. Now, what I'd like to know is who is taking hair and accessories and who is taking makeup classes?
Well, of course, Miss Candy is the dance tutor here at the Box Hill TAFE. And of course, I coach them in all their words and, you know, all their lyrics for the big songs that, and, you know, basically mime technique. So, you know, I think that we'll be exporting a much higher quality standard of drag artists in the coming years.
That's fabulous. We look forward to that. Miss Candy, will you be actually lecturing?
Well, I, of course, I am doing deportment, grace and style, and just a general clean and good grooming. I think that's really important. And, of course, I am doing work with dialogue so that the people always sound really classy when they finish their number, and I'm very proud of that.
Yes, I think it's really important, Miss Candy, that all our drag artists speak real proper.
It is, it's very important. Now, I noticed too the original numbers that you had tonight. Things like Don't Rain on My Parade. I mean, the audience was going berserk. Now, you know us gay people, we've seen it before. How did you select this material?
Well, it was very hard, but the final choice was made a little bit easier because they were the only numbers we could remember.
Fabulous. Now, Miss Candy, that fabulous... Oh, Lindy Chandler. It was fabulous to see that again, and the crowd went a little bit berserk. I noticed a few shocked faces.
Yes, well, of course, that is one of my wonderful, my brilliant impersonations, of course. Apart from Lindy, I also do a very, very brilliant Shirley Bassey, and I do an equally brilliant Divine.
That's the one. Okay, now I'm starting to sweat like mad amongst all this glitz and glitter. I believe it's your last night, so all you punters out there and our viewer have missed the show. Hopefully they do bring it into the suburbs. How about that?
Oh, this is it. I mean, with it, a diploma subject in the TAFE colleges throughout Victoria, you know, the great thing about drag, it'll soon be a VCE subject. So there's a whole lot of TAFE colleges and high schools that we've yet to tour. So, you know, if you haven't seen our show, please speak to your local headmaster, and I'm sure he'll book us for the canteen. We're quite happy to do matinees. We're a lot prettier after dark, but what the heck. We're quite happy to do matinees. In fact, we're quite happy for any work, really.
Fabulous. And any more from you, Miss Candy?
That's all I can say. If you do decide to book us, you've guaranteed a one thing. It's going to be a stylish and a real classy show. I make that a commitment. A commitment to glamour and class.
Well, you know who I'll be getting for my next bar mitzvah. It's Lindsay signing off from another Queer Zone, and it's good night from, well, you know who they are. And if you don't, well, get over it.